welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, here we are. It's episode number 800. Have a tip today sent in by Johann. Johann's from Mexico City, and he was watching podcast 776, where I showed how to create this chart where we could show the unders, the averages, and the overs, basically creating something sort of like conditional formatting. And Johann says, well, wait, there's a much better way to do this. Let's do conditional formatting on every single month. So here we have our results for each of the months, and basically, you know, if we are over 100%, we're in green. Somewhere in between is yellow, and then the things under 50% are in red. Well, that's a cool chart. Let's take a look at how we create that. First of all, you start with your data up here that has all of the scores for each month, and then we're going to build in a hidden section of the worksheet some formulas. And you know, the first formula says, hey, if we're greater than 1, if we're greater than 100%, then bring that value down. Otherwise, bring a 0, and that's for the green series. And then the red series says, if that value up in B2 is less than 50%, bring the value down, otherwise a 0. And then the one in the middle, the yellow, just basically says, hey, we're going to take whatever's in B2 minus whatever's in the red, whatever's in the green. That's going to give us everything in between. So when I copy this formula across, what we're going to end up with is basically 3 series now, and it's going to indicate whether the data should be red, yellow, or green. Now, I'm going to create the chart as a regular column chart, and initially, first of all, the colors are all wrong, so I'm going to click here on this series, and I see that that's series yellow, so I can go to my paint bucket icon and change that to yellow. We'll go to the next series, I'll choose series green, and again, the paint bucket to change that to green, and then finally, series red, and the paint bucket to change that to red. But this is not the best result at all, because we have, the charts are kind of staggered. So I'm going to go in and format this series, and go back to the options tab. The options tab, is different depending on what your chart type is. First thing I want to do is I want to set the overlap from 0 to 100, and that's going to force the red, yellow, and green bars to appear directly on top of each other. And that works perfectly here because only one of them is going to appear for each month. And then maybe play with the gap width a little bit to make those columns a little bit wider. Click OK, and there we end up with our result. Basically, looks like we've applied conditional formatting to each column, but really behind the scenes, we're just breaking this out into 3 series. The thing that makes it a little bit tough is having to go in and format the series using the options tab to change the gap width and the overlap. The overlap's the important one, to 100%, to make sure that all of those columns appear directly on top of each other. Thanks to Johann for sending it in, and thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you on Monday for episode number 801.